Students, welcome back to our channel. Today I'll explain you how to change a normal sentence into a question or an interrogative sentence. I'll show you how to change that normal sentence into a question. Okay, so first sentence we have today is his mother speaks English well. So as you people can see this sentence, ikkada ee sentence lo manam chusinatlayite ganaka his mother speaks English well an undanamata. So ee sentence lo manam em gamaninchali, first subject entity ane chodali. So idi subject, so idi verb, idi object. Okay, so here subject, verb and object we got. First of all, you have to identify what is the verb in this sentence. Ee sentence lo verb enti? Speaks. ओके सो दी आइडेंटिफाई चेयाली मनं दानि ओक इंट्रोगेटिव सेंटेंस गा मार्चालन्ना ओक नेगेटिव सेंटेंस गा मार्चालन्ना ओक क्वेश्चन गा मार्चालन्ना ओक क्वेश्चन टैग गा मार्चालन्ना प्रति दानिकी मनकु वर्ब अनेटुवंटिदि चाला 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 इंपार्टेंट अन्नमाट सो अंदुकनि वर्ब नि मनं आइडेंटिफाई चेयाली सो इक्कड स्पीक अंटे डू उंदनि मनं अनुकोवालन्नमाट सो इदि वी1 स्पोक अंटे वी2 अंटे आ प्लेस लो मनं डिड तीसुकोवाली स्पोकन Done. Okay, so ilaaga theesukovalamata. Ade ganaka third person singular ankonde. He, she, it. Ivi third person singular anamata. So ivanni okka okka subject anamata. He ante okka abbai, she ante okka ammai, it ante okkadi, edaina okkata anamata. So ala cheppetappudu alanti samayamlo kachithanga verb edi use chesinappatiki adi speak aina, learn aina, तरवाता ईट अयिना ए वर्ब अयिना तीसुकोंडी एप्पुडैते ही शी ईट अनेटुवंटि सिंगुलर सब्जेक्ट्स तो स्टार्ट अवुतुदो दानिकि एस फॉर्म अनेदि याड चेयाली खच्चितंगा सो स्पीक्स ही स्पीक्स शी स्पीक्स इट स्पीक्स ही ईट्स शी ईट्स ही लर्न्स शी लर्न्स इट लर्न्स सो इक्कड हिज मदर अनेटुवंटिदि मीकु इप्पुडु ओक डौट रावोच्चु हिज मदर अनेदि इक्कड शी गानि ही गानि इट कादु कदा आयना एस फॉर्म एंदुकु यूज चेशारु अनि His mother అనేటువంటిది ఒక సబ్జెక్ట్ ఏ కదా సో ఇట్ ఇస్ అ సింగులర్ సబ్జెక్ట్ అంటే ఒక్క మనిషి గురించే మనం మాట్లాడుతున్నాం అన్నమాట సో ఎప్పుడైనా సరే సింగులర్ సబ్జెక్ట్ అనేది మనకు వచ్చింది అంటే సో అప్పుడు మనం ఏం చేయాలంటే ఎస్ ఫామ్ అనేటువంటిది వర్బ్ కి యాడ్ చేయాలి సో ఇది సింగులర్ సబ్జెక్ట్ హిస్ మదర్ అనేది ఒక్కళ్ళే కాబట్టి సో దానికి మనం ప్లూరల్ వర్బ్ అనేది యూస్ చేసాం ప్లూరల్ వర్బ్ అంటే నథింగ్ బట్ వి యాడెడ్ ఎస్ ఫామ్ టు దట్ వర్బ్ సో దెన్ వి కెన్ కాల్ ఇట్ యాస్ అ ప్లూరల్ వర్బ్ అందుకని హిస్ మదర్ స్పీక్స్ ఇంగ్లీష్ వెల్ అని చెప్పి అన్నాం అన్నమాట సో ఇక్కడ మనం ఏం చేయాలంటే సో ఇక్కడ స్పీక్స్ అనేది ఉంది కాబట్టి నేను ఇక్కడ థర్డ్ పర్సన్ సింగులర్ వచ్చినప్పుడు ఎస్ ఫామ్ అని చెప్పా కాబట్టి సో ఇక్కడ కూడా స్పీక్స్ అనేది వచ్చింది ఎస్ ఫామ్ యాడ్ చేయాలి ఒక్క సింగులర్ సబ్జెక్ట్ కాబట్టి సో అలాంటి సమయంలో మనం డస్ తీసుకోవాలన్నమాట సో దాని యొక్క అబ్సెన్స్ లో మనం ఏం తీసుకోవాలంటే డస్ తీసుకోవాలన్నమాట సో ఇక్కడ స్పీక్ ఉంటేనేమో డూ తీసుకోవాలి స్పోక్ ఉంటేనేమో డిడ్ తీసుకోవాలి స్పోకెన్ ఉంటే డన్ తీసుకోవాలి స్పీక్ ఉంటే డస్ తీసుకోవాలి స్పీక్ అనేటువంటిది ఏమో వి1 స్పోక్ అనేటువంటిది వి2 स्पोकर अने वी थ्री स्पीक्स अने मन की सिंपल प्रेजेंट टेंस थर्ड पर्सन सिंगुलर सब्जेक्ट्स वच्चिनप्पुडु अप्पुडु एस फॉर्म अने मन ऐड चेस्तां सिंगुलर सब्जेक्ट अयिते वस्तुदो सिंगुलर सब्जेक्ट अंटे ऐ कूडा सिंगुलर सब्जेक्टे कानी दानिकि स्पीक्स मन रायकूडदु सो देयर आर सम एक्सेप्शन्स सो अट्लागे इदि चूसिनट्लयिते सिंपल प्रेजेंट टेंस इदि सिंपल पास्ट टेंस पास्ट पार्टिसिपल इदेमो सिंपल प्रेजेंट टेंस लो थर्ड पर्सन सिंगुलर सब्जेक्ट वच्चिनप्पुडु इट्लागे रायालन्नमाट सो दीस आर द रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन्स यू हैव टू रिमेंबर व्हाइल यू आर चेंजिंग A normal sentence into an question, okay, or an interrogative sentence, okay. Sentence: Sheila likes chocolates. Sheila likes chocolates very much. Okay, so this is the sentence. Sheila likes chocolates very much. So ee sentence lo kuda manam em chusukovali ante ee sentence lo kuda subject enti Sheila anedi subject likes anedi verb chocolates object. Okay, manam ikkada chusukunte chalu so manaki ikkada sambandhinchinatuvantadi entante manaki eppudaina verb kavali indaka sentence lo nenu cheppinattu so likes anetuvantadi ఎస్ ఫామ్ లో ఉంది కాబట్టి లైక్స్ లో ఎప్పుడైనా సరే మనం డస్ తీసుకోవాలి शीला अने सिंगुलर सब्जेक्ट काबट्टी यस फॉर्म वच्चिंदि शीला अने मनुषे काबट्टी इक्कड लाइक्स अनेदी ऐड चेसामु सो लाइक्स वच्चिनप्पुडु एप्पुडैना सरे मनं डस्ट तीसुकोवाली प्लेस लो सो ई लाइक्स कास्त मनं इक्कड रासुकोवालन्नमाट सो लाइक्स प्लेस लो मनं डस्ट रासुकोवाली इक्कड चेप्पिनट्टु डस् తర్వాత ఈ సబ్జెక్ట్ ఇక్కడికి వస్తుందన్నమాట షీలా ఫస్ట్ లెటర్ క్యాపిటల్ లో రాయాలి ఎందుకంటే నేమ్ కాబట్టి నెక్స్ట్ లైక్ రాయాలి లైక్స్ రాయకూడదు డస్ షీలా లైక్ చాక్లెట్స్ వెరీ మచ్ ఇక్కడ ఉన్నది యాస్ ఇట్ ఇస్ మనం ఇక్కడ రాసేసుకుంటాం క్వశ్చన్ మార్క్ సో డస్ లైక్స్ ప్లేస్ లో వి రోట్ డస్ దెన్ వి రోట్ ద సబ్జెక్ట్ హియర్ Then we wrote like no yes form because we wrote already in does like chocolates we wrote you as usual and very much also we copied exactly in the same sentence okay exactly on the above sentence okay so this is the way of changing a normal sentence into an interrogative sentence sentence he sometimes comes home very late so here you have to understand what is a verb in this sentence comes is a verb okay so this is the verb first of all you have to identify in which tense it is so it is in simple present tense because we are using the third person singular so that's why comes yes form should be added to the verb as I told you already in the earlier section of this video then comes whenever you find this kind of a verb okay so there you have to imagine as if you have does okay so first of all you have to write that verb here okay in the place of comes we are writing does okay first of all you have to write the verb okay so verb comes here so d should be capital letter then you are writing the subject does he here we wrote the capital letter but small letter now then sometimes come you have to write here because we wrote already yes form here so that's why come then you can write the remaining sentence as it is so this is the way of changing okay this kind of a sentence so whenever you find comes yes form in the verb there you have to imagine does okay so the does comes here in the front section of a sentence then you have to write the subject okay so you can write sometimes usually these kinds of sentences these kinds of words would not be there in sentences very rarely okay so it's not very quite often so now we got this word sometimes then you can write the whole sentence as it is but you should not write yes form here because we already wrote yes in does okay so this is the way of constructing this is the way of making an interrogative sentence okay this book costs only 12 rupees okay so this is the sentence we have in order to change so when you are talking about the note then you have to say 12 rupee note not 12 rupees if you are telling about the currency only without note without mentioning the note then you can say 12 rupees if you are talking about the note 12 rupee note 100 rupee note so that is the way of telling okay so 12 rupee note will not be there but as I wanted to make you understand the plural note so that's why I said okay so here this book costs only 12 rupees this is a singular subject because only one book is available here so this can be the singular subject so as we wrote only the singular subject so here you have to so this book can be considered as it as I told you third person singular he she it so it can be considered as it okay so this book can be it so as we are using this one so verb can for can be formed as yes form okay costs so when you find this kind of a verb then you have to imagine does okay so then you can write this cause as we took in the place of cause we took does so we wrote here then this book the subject comes here this verb without yes form then you can write the whole sentence as it is సో ఇలాగా రాయాలన్నమాట సో ఎప్పుడైనా సరే మనకి ఎస్ ఫామ్ ఉన్నటువంటి సెంటెన్స్ వస్తే అక్కడ డస్ ఫామ్ తీసుకొని అది రాసిన తర్వాత ఇక్కడ సబ్జెక్ట్ ని రాసి సబ్జెక్ట్ రాసిన తర్వాత ఇక్కడ ఉన్నటువంటి వర్బ్ ఎస్ ఫామ్ ని ఒమిట్ చేసి రాసిన తర్వాత మిగతా సెంటెన్స్ అంతా ఉన్నట్టున్నట్టు రాసి ఇక్కడ క్వశ్చన్ మార్క్ పెడితే దెన్ వి కెన్ మేక్ ఆన్ ఇంట్రోగేటివ్ సెంటెన్స్ సో దే స్విమ్ ఇన్ ద లేక్ ఎవ్రీ డే దే స్విమ్ ఇన్ ద లేక్ ఎవ్రీ డే okay so they swim in the lake every day so here it is also a regular action in simple present tense so they is a plural subject so that's why we didn't add any s form they means more than one that is plural subject okay so whenever you get a plural subject you'll get singular verb no s form but if you get a singular subject there you have to write a plural verb okay so ekkadaina sare ekku mandu unnappudu ఇక్కడ ఎస్ ఫామ్ రాదన్నమాట సో ఒక్కళ్ళే ఉన్నప్పుడు ఇక్కడ ఎస్ ఫామ్ వస్తుంది అంటే హీ షీ ఇట్ అనే వాళ్ళు ఒక్కళ్ళే కాబట్టి ఇక్కడ ఎస్ ఫామ్ యాడ్ చేస్తాము దే అనేటువంటి అంటే చాలా మంది కాబట్టి దే అంటే వాళ్ళు అంటే చాలా మంది కాబట్టి సో ఇక్కడ ఎస్ ఫామ్ అనేది రాదన్నమాట సో ఇట్లా రాయాలి సో హియర్ యు హావ్ టు ఇమాజిన్ యు హావ్ టు ఐడెంటిఫై ఫస్ట్ వాట్ ఈస్ ఎ వర్బ్ ఇన్ దిస్ సెంటెన్స్ స్విమ్ ఈస్ ఎ వర్బ్ యాజ్ యు నో ఆల్రెడీ సో ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ వి వన్ ఓకే సో స్విమ్ ఓకే ఇట్ ఈస్ వి వన్ So it is in the first form. So when you find this kind of a verb, you have to imagine do in the place of that. Okay. So here you have to write do only. Okay. If you get swims, then does. Okay. So as we got only swim, only do. So do has to come here. Then the subject they. Okay. Then the verb normally. So whenever you get. So do they swim? Then you can write the remaining sentence as it is. In the lake every day? Question mark. Question mark is also very important. If you wouldn't keep the question mark, you may not gain all the marks. So it is very important. So do they swim in the lake every day? So this is the way of writing. Okay. So we wrote the verb here. So in the place of swim, we wrote do. Okay. We imagine do. So we wrote do. Then we wrote the subject here they, then the verb as it is swim, then we wrote in the lake every day. So this is the way of changing this kind of a sentence into a question tag. Okay, so next one, we learn English at school. This is another sentence. Oh, here. You have to identify the verb first. So this is the verb, and it is V1. So whenever you find V1, so let me show you the three forms: learn, learned, and learned. So this is the verb in which you can write the two forms: regular form and also the irregular form. So if it is a regular form, this is V1, V2, and V3. So if I have to tell you the irregular form. Learn, learnt, and learned. Okay, so these are the forms. This is V1, V2, and V3. Okay, so in the place of V1, you have to use do. V2 did. V3 done. Third person singular learns. Okay, so here does. Same thing here also. Do, did, done. If it is learns, same verb, but I wrote in all the forms. Like it is a regular verb and it is a irregular verb. We can write this verb in both the ways. Okay. So here we learn English at school. So learn is V1. Okay. So as I already told you, it is in the first form of the verb, simple present tense. That means it is a regular action. Every day it happens. Okay. So. And we is more than one person, so that's why we wrote singular subject. So no yes form. If you got many people here, then you cannot add yes form here. ఇక్కడ చాలా మంది we అంటే మేము అంటే ఒకలకన్నా ఎక్కువ మంది కాబట్టి ఇక్కడ yes అనే form ని మనం add చేయలేదు అన్నమాట. So ఇది plural subject కాదు. So అలా ఉన్నప్పుడు ఇక్కడ do ని మనం imagine చేసుకోవాలి కాబట్టి. So you have to write do here. Okay. So we wrote verb here, then subject we do we. Then the verb then you can write the whole sentence as it is. English at school. Okay, you can write the whole sentence as it is, but question mark is necessary because we are changing that sentence as a question or an interrogative sentence. Okay, so that's why that is very important. We need to write the question mark also. Okay, he writes to only. He writes to his mother every week. Okay, W-E-A-K, week means not stronger. Okay, but this week, days of a week. Okay, so he writes to his mother every week. So this is the sentence. So first of all, you have to identify the verb. So this is the verb. Okay, so writes. You have to imagine does here because we got yes form. And this is the third person singular. That's why we wrote yes form to the verb. In simple present tense, third person singular he. Okay, it is a singular subject. So that's why we got plural verb yes form. So after that, you have to imagine does there. So that's why I'm writing does. Then you can write the subject. Okay, so does he. Then write. No, yes. Yes already came here. Okay, so does he write to, then you can write the whole sentence as it is. To his mother every week. Okay, every week. Then question mark. Okay, so that is the way of writing. Then next sentence. So here Nightingale sings sweetly. So this is the sentence we got. So Nightingale can be the singular subject. So whenever you get a singular subject, you will get plural verb like sings. Okay, so whenever you add yes form, then that can be the plural verb. So here plural verb like we, they, then you have to write singular verb, no yes form. Okay, so that is the example. So that you can't forget. So Nightingale can be considered as it, thing. Okay, animal can also be considered as it only. So that's why it, so it can be accompanied by yes form, sing sweetly. So in the place of sings, you have to take does. Okay, so does, the verb comes here. Okay, and then the Nightingale, the subject comes here. The Nightingale then no yes form, just sing in the whole sentence only sweetly. Okay, so sweetly. Question mark. Does the Nightingale sing sweetly? So this is the way of changing. Singular subject always accompanies the plural verb. Like Nightingale is a singular subject, so sings plural verb. And the plural subjects like we, they are singular verb like sing. No yes form. Okay, so this is the rule you have to remember. And the next one. Mr. Advani drives to his office every day. Mr. Advani. So let me tell you the sentence. Mr. Advani drives to his office every day. So that is a regular action. So whenever you are telling about the regular action, that can be the simple present tense. Mr. Advani drives to his office every day. Okay, so this is the sentence. Mr. Advani is a subject, drives is a verb, to his office. Okay, so this can be the object and it is a preposition. Anyway, we need only the verb. So verb drives can be does here. So does comes here, that means the verb comes here, does. In the place of drives, we are writing does. So verbs comes in the subject's place and Mr. Advani comes in the verb's place. So Mr. Advani can be capital only, no more small letters, because the name of a person, and when you are giving respect to a person, Mr. can also be a capital letter. Does Mr. Advani. Okay, so we wrote the verb here, then the subject and the verb. Indirect verb we wrote, helping verb. Then drive, physical verb, action verb. Drive, no yes form because we already wrote here. Then you can start writing the whole sentence as it is. To his office every day. then question mark. Okay, so this is the way of changing. Mr. Advani drives to his office every day. So does Mr. Advani drive to his office every day? So no need to keep full stop or anything. You have to keep the question mark at the end of the sentence because it is an interrogative or the question. The sun rises in the east. Last sentence. The sun rises in the east every morning. Okay, morning, that is